The full design of our robot. For the robot base, we are using transparent perplex. And then on the base, you can see that we have two Arduino boards here. One is for the sensor and actuator. The other one is for the motor for wheel movement. For the motor controller, the first motor drive is for the front two wheels, and the second motor drive is for the back two wheels. So for the robot arm, this is the design of our robot arm. We are using servo motor to rotate the robot joints. So you can see this servo motor is for the movement rotation in the Z axis. This servo motor is for the movement of Y axis. So this is our robot arm 1, this robot arm 2. For the arm 3, which is the porter, we also use the servo motor, which enable it to rotate in a wide range of degree. Robot arm 1 and robot arm 2 are made of wood. For the porter arm, it's made of plastic porter, and there's a wharf here for the ping pong ball to get through. And this is the tilt sensor, and this is the LED light. At the bottom of our robot, we have LED and also photoresistor. So the LED lights will hit the ground and then detected by our photo sensor. However, if our robot reaches the tape borderline, less light is detected by the photo sensor. So it will trigger the piezo buzzer to warn us that we should not go beyond the line. So this is very important to make sure that our robot only plays within the competition region. The batteries are at the bottom of the robot base. We are using 4 hobby gear motors to control the 4 wheels. And this is the ultrasonic sensor. After we have collected enough of balls, the robot will go back to the collecting bucket. So when the ultrasonic sensor senses that the bucket is close enough, it will automatically trigger the servo motor to open the gate and also the vibration motor to vibrate the storage space for the balls to slide out. We choose this robot arm design because normal mechanical clamp can only contain 1 or 2 ping pong balls at one time. But for our design, we can contain up to 5 or 6 ping pong balls at one time. And then after we gather all the ping pong balls, we can just pour it into this storage space. This storage is made of wood. So when it gets enough number of balls, the robot will travel back to the collecting bucket and then open this gate to release all the ping pong balls. So this is very important because it saves our time. We don't need to get back to the collecting bucket every time after we collect 1 or 2 ping pong balls. We can collect many ping pong balls at one go and then travel back to collecting bucket to release all the balls at one time only. The gate here is covered with soft material, which is sponge. So when the balls roll down here, it will reduce the impact force of balls, so the balls will not bounce off.
For the wheel part, the aim is for the car to move forward and to move backward, and to the turn right and to the turn left. And then the car, we upgrade when the car, we can accelerate the car and decelerate it. And then the sensor we use, we have 2 push-up buttons, the switch sensor and 1 potentiometer. So the 2 push-up buttons, one for the car to move forward, we push it and the car will go forward. And then the another one, the push up button, when we push, and then the car will move backward. Potentiometer, we use for the car to turn to the left or to the right, according to the code, which is to the left less than 500 and to the right more than 1020. And then for the switch meter, to make the car in the mode which is accelerate, and the car in the mode of decelerate.
So now we will test the speed control. This is the switch for the speed control. Now it's 20 something RPM. now become 143 RPM. If I turn off the switch, the motor becomes slower. If I turn it on, the motor becomes faster. So now we test the forward button, which is this push button. If I push the button, I set it to low speed so you can see the rotation of the motor clearly. So as you can see, all the rotation of the motor is in the same direction, pretty much forward. This is the down button. If I push this button, you can see all the motor are rotating backwards. So although this is positive, this is negative, actually they are rotating in the same direction because we install the motor in opposite orientation. If I rotate the potential meter to the left, you can see that this motor and this motor are going up. This motor and this motor are going down. So the result is the robot will turn to the left. If I turn the potential meter to the right, you can see that this motor and this motor are going up. This motor and this motor are going down. So the robot will turn right. We are using servo motor to control the robot arm movement. So the sensor here are potential meter and the actuator are servo motors. So this servo motor will be connected to the robot arm. This is for robot arm 1, robot arm 2, and bottom arm.
So today I will be explaining about how to detect the orientation of bottom robot arm. So we have used sensor and actuator, which is tip sensor and engine. So we have added tip sensor at the bottom. So the tip sensor is usually used to detect 90 degrees. So why we need to detect 90 degrees? Because it will be easier for us to collect the pre-form ball. So when it is not in 90 degree angle, the pre-form ball will be slippery and won't get into the bottle easily. So for information, we will be pierced the bottle of the bottle with a knife, so the ball will be go in and will be gathered from the upper position, which will get into the storage of our robot arm. So when the bottle is 90 degree position, the ball will be go into the bottle and the LED will be notify us. So in order to catch the ball, the bottle has to be in 90 degree position, which is like this. So when it is not in 90 degree position, the ball cannot get into the bottle. It will be slip away from the bottle. When the tilt sensor detects 90 degree position, the LED will notify us. So we will proceed to lower the bottle in order to collect the ball. Okay.
So we have used sensor and actuator in this our robot bottle arm. So why we need the sensor and actuator is because when we are controlling our robot from afar, we cannot see the perfect 90 degree angle. So we need to know the 90 degree angle. So we use tilt sensor to detect 90 degree and we use the LED to notify us to proceed with lower the robot arm in order to collect the ball.
Hi, I'm Leona. I'm from Team Robot Eagles. So I will be explaining about the use of ultrasonic sensor in our robot. The input of ultrasonic sensor will be sent to the Arduino Uno, and the output will be sent to the actuator, which is a vibration motor and also servo motor. Ultrasonic sensor is being placed at the back of the robot. It is used to sense the distance between the robot and the collecting box. And for the servo motor and vibration motor, it is placed at the side of the robot. The purpose that we use ultrasonic sensor is because we hope that the gate of the storage will be opened automatically instead of we control it manually. So the distance between the robot and the collecting box is the input from the ultrasonic sensor. It will be sent to the Arduino Uno and will be processed into useful output. So when the distance is less than 4 cm, the servo motor will rotate at 90 degrees so that the gate of the storage will be opened. At the same time, the vibration motor will be triggered to ensure that the ball dropping session runs smoothly. So this is the flowchart for controlling the storage gate. So the input will be keep sending from the ultrasonic sensor to the Arduino. So the distance will be calculated based on this formula. So if the distance is less than 4 cm and greater than 0 cm, which means the robot is very close to the collecting box, the servo motor will rotate to 90 degrees, so the gate will be open and the vibrator will be turned on. However, if it is the distance is greater than 4 cm, which means the collecting box is still very far away from the robot, the servo motor will rotate back to 0 degrees, which means the gate will be closed and the vibrator will be turned off. Okay, for the first condition is when the distance between ultrasonic sensor and the collecting box is more than 4 cm. We can see that the storage gate is still closed. However, when the distance between ultrasonic sensor and collecting box is less than 4 cm, the storage gate is now open and the vibrator is turned off. Okay, so now let's watch the TimberTech simulation for better understanding.
Okay, next we're going to talk about how to limit the robot movement within the designated area only, which is actually 90-90 cm, as being proposed by the completion guideline. So in this part, we're going to use a sensor which is actually photoresistor, which comes along with LED, and the actuator is actually the piezoelectric buzzer. So the photoresistor detects input from the light intensity of the surface of the tiles. So as soon as it detects the border of the designated area, which is actually the dull black surface which have the intensity of 650 and above, it will immediately ring. So when the piezoelectric buzzer rings, it indicates that the robot is about to go out from the designated area. So as soon as it starts ringing, we will know that we need to go back as soon as possible.
What?